Let's talk about project risk responses. I'll explain how the main risk response strategies look like in the real world. So, as always, I'll give you examples. And also, I'll tell you how to integrate the risk responses into your project. So, let's dive in. The risk response planning is a process of identifying what you will do with all risks in your risk register. By the way, if you don't know the overall project risk management framework, you can watch this video, I'll leave you a link in the description. There are five main risk response strategies for threats or negative risks, and we'll talk about responses for opportunities later in this video. The first risk response strategy is called avoid. It means you need to do something to eliminate the cause of the threat. So, what are the examples from the real world? You can remove a work package or deliverable from WBS to secure the delivery of the rest of the project. Or you can remove a conflicting team member to stop demotivation of the whole team. Or, more typical example, you can forbid any work in bad weather to avoid the risk that someone gets injured. The next strategy is to mitigate a risk. You need to do something to reduce the impact or the probability of a threat. So, for example, you can create a prototype for a deliverable with unclear requirements as early as possible and get feedback from your customers. This way, you'll reduce probability of change requests at the end of the project. You can also plan frequent visits to a vendor to learn about problems as early as possible. It reduces the probability of unexpected problems and miscommunications. It's a must when you outsource a part of the project to another organization that is not under your direct control. Less obvious example is to employ a part-time legal or procurement expert if you don't have one in your company. It will mitigate problems in the areas of expertise where you lack proficiency. Also, an excellent example of mitigation of risks is training your project team in risk management. This way you identify more risks and reduce the overall risk level of the project. Okay, moving on to the next strategy. It is called transfer. Here you take action to make another party responsible for the risk. So outsourcing a part of the project is an example of transferring risks. But as you just saw, risk responses are never perfect. Most of them produce secondary risks. So you should be careful not to overlook them. And another example of transferring risks is to buy insurance on the property or equipment. The next strategy is to actively accept a risk. It means that you need to develop a contingency plan and make reserves of time and money for these risks. However, you will only act if and when the risk happens. So, for example, if a critical person gets sick, we'll start looking for a substitution. If a work package takes more time, we'll work overtime. If the equipment breaks, we'll buy a new piece using the reserves. Okay, last but not least, we can decide to passively accept a risk. We do absolutely nothing. If the risk happens, only then you will determine if there is an impact and what can we do. Maybe there is a workaround. For example, there is a small chance of a tropical storm around the date of an event that we organize. We may decide to do nothing about it for now. And we'll see if we need to do something about the event when the storm hits the area. And if it even hits on our date at all. Okay, let me show you how it all looks in a real risk register. Then we'll move to the risk response strategies for opportunities. And if you want to learn more about risk register or you want to get my template, I'll leave you the link in the description to this video. So in the risk register, you will have a unique index for risk, 0013. The VBS element number it impacts is 165. The category is HR in this example. Description: resources for mobile development are limited and in high demand. Effects of the risk: the availability of developers may cause delays in the work packages, and quality may suffer due to multitasking. The probability is 8, the impact is 8, risk rank is 64. The owner of the risk is J&K, recruitment. Our response plan is that recruiters will prioritize hiring people for our vacant roles starting next week. That's our primary plan. Also, we'll develop a cross-project HR plan together with PMs Anna Smith and Ron Neagle. We'll secure the required resources from other projects if needed. That's our contingency plan. And if you want to see more of the real-world examples of risk management, I have an article on that as well. I'll leave you a link in the description. By the way, if you enjoyed this video so far, please give it a thumbs up right now and subscribe if you haven't already. I'll wait for a minute here. Okay, not a minute, just a few seconds. Okay, let's talk about strategies to take advantage of opportunities on a project. There are 5 of them as well. First of all, exploit an opportunity. So you do some extra work or change the project plan to make an opportunity appear. For example, you can try suggesting a new solution or even a new product to get a new contract from your current client. Also, you can find and suggest a better approach to reduce the required efforts. This can help you to fit into the deadlines. Or, for example, book tickets to visit the vendor's site in advance and in bulk to increase the profit margin from your project. The next strategy is to enhance the opportunity. Do something to increase chances or the impact of this opportunity. For example, you can plan difficult work packages for the most experienced team members to finish them faster and with fewer defects. That's an opportunity to get some buffers of time and costs. And by the way, that's something that you need to do by default. Also, you can try to buy equipment during discount periods, when the price is lower. Or you can negotiate the transfer of an expert you need as early as possible until he is assigned to another project. Or you can try motivating the team to work harder to finish the project in advance and get the incentive bonus for the early delivery. But for sure, it should be a part of the contract or an agreement. The last strategy is to share the opportunity. Here you will share benefits with another party for an opportunity to happen for both of you. Usually it means you'll create a partnership with a third party to achieve project goals. If you have any reasonable examples of this strategy, please write them in the comments below. Thank you in advance. And for sure, you can actively and passively accept opportunities like with the threats. Also, there is an additional risk response strategy. You can escalate the risk. So do something to get engagement from a stakeholder who can eliminate or mitigate the risk. And yes, there is a group of risks that you can't handle as a project manager. But there might be a person who can handle it relatively easy. So you need to reach out to him and get some of his attention. But his or her attention is usually precious, so you use it carefully. By the way, the sponsor of this video is my free career change cheat sheet. It's challenging and overwhelming to get your first project management role. This cheat sheet gives you an action plan to get a promotion to a PM in the nearest future. If you want to become a project manager, you need to get your copy. Link is in the description. So, we talked about risk responses and possible actions you can take. But what is a risk response in your project management plan? And here you need to understand this. Your risk management efforts are a part of your project. It's not something that stands alone. It means a risk response plan may require updating project scope. So, for example, adding or removing deliverables, work packages or tasks. You may need to update project budget, like adding reserves and allocating money for additional work, resources or expertise. You may need to update the schedule as well. For example, starting work on specific dates or adding reserves of time for critical tasks. But likewise, you may need to introduce new processes and workflows. You may need to hire a particular expert or consultant, or you'll decide to outsource part of the project scope to a third party. It means you need to find a vendor, sign a contract, create a scope of work, and so on. Also, keep in mind that some risk responses might be quite complicated. You'll need approvals from your key stakeholders, Some of them may have a different opinion on the risks and possible responses, so you'll have to work closely with them to get their buy-in. By the way, you plan risk responses later during project planning, so you'll need to update the required areas of the project management plan with the responses you created. You need to check and ensure that risk responses don't put you beyond project deadlines or over budget. By the way, should you create risk response plans for all known risks? Should we really do something about each risk? And the answer is no, you can't eliminate all the risks. It's barely possible, and for sure it's unpractical. You do need to operate within constraints of budget, time and scope. Your risk management activities should be adequate to the project constraints and its importance in general. Here's the problem. Risk responses are important, but they are only as good as your risk management approach in general. So, I strongly recommend you watch the video on the risk management process next. And if you need a template on My Risk Register, check the video on that as well. Click one of these videos now and I'll see you there.